Union Bank of India, Savitribai Phule, Pune University, Department of Students Welfare, Excellent Professional Academy, Vision Alpha and Vanarecha, No Escape, Vodafone, Bank of Maharashtra, Proton Training Solutions, Crazy Cheesy, Nescafe, The Chai, Hinge, Indian Success Stories. Thank you all.
As Nalal Bushnell has quoted, a true entrepreneur is a doer, not a dreamer. MEVEL is an entrepreneurship and intrapreneurship development program that aims to promote their skills among students and generate increasingly efficient entrepreneurs who will not only change India but the world. Today's honorable guest also has a multifaceted career profile. Being a renowned management professional, he is also a socio-economic expert, an international project management expert, an orator, and a writer. With the expertise in senior level management for past 28 years, he has successfully led cross-functional teams across the globe. He is a coach, a trainer, a strategist, a director, a trustee, a spokesperson for an NGO, Arthakranti, and last but not least, an eminent actor.
He is Mr. DEEPAK KARANJKAR. I would like to request Rohan Patil, Dheeraj, Ankita to escort Mr. KARANJKAR on the dais. And the vice principal also. And the principal also.
Have a big round of applause, guys. Pursuing his degree in engineering, his interest in management guided him to pursue a career in business management. A SAP consultant by profession, Mr. KARANJKAR has completed process engineering, reverse engineering, workflow management, and various other management courses at Stanford Park.
Mr. KARANJKAR has developed his own proven methodology for business process re-engineering projects. He has led and successfully completed several multinational projects as an effective project director. He is the founder, mentor for executive consortiums in US. He has also worked closely with Wall Street in US and has led many mergers and acquisition projects. He is also working as a visiting faculty member with some of the most reputed US universities for their management programs. Mr. KARANJKAR emphasizes that people and process management is the key expertise, and performance and potential are the key areas of working for a successful business. World Bank and International Monetary Fund for developing countries, global economy pitfalls, GDP, a deceitful dimension of progress, and strategy building for organizations and utilities are a few of his lectures titled delivered at national and international forum. Apart from his profession, Mr. KARANJKAR is a well-versed actor for the last 25 years. He has performed versatile role plays, TV serial, movies in English, Marathi and Hindi.
He was felicitated with Acclaimed Actor Award for State of Maharashtra. He is trustee and chief secretary of Akhil Bharatiya Marathi Natya Parishad. He has also directed a mega opera on Marathi poetry while he stay in US. Now, I would like to welcome Dr. Saroj Hiravat ma'am to podium to felicitate Mr. KARANJKAR sir.
Thank you, Nupur. I'm not going to felicitate them. I'm just going to declare the felicitation. Anyways, thank you very much. I request our vice principal and principal to felicitate our honorable guest, DEEPAK KARANJKAR. I request the students to get the gifts one by one and hand it over to the principal and vice principal, please.
Come talk fast.
Thank you.
thank both the principal and vice principal for doing the honors. I'll just read out the citation which we, in the honor of Honorable DEEPAK KARANJKAR, and then we can hand over the citation to him. Honorable DEEPAK KARANJKAR is a renowned management proficient, writer, socio-economic expert and an actor. You have over 30 years of distinguished and versatile experience at senior management level. Your passionate personality has transformed people and processes while making you a success in the field of management. Your excellence, brilliance and leadership tactics is absolutely praiseworthy. In recognition of your remarkable work, SP College is honored to present this citation. The citation, please. Thank you very much for the patient listen. I now request Nupur and her co-partner to come and take charge of the mic, please. Thank you.
Thank you, ma'am. Now, I would like to request Mr. Karanjkar to enlighten us with his thoughts and views on the intrapreneurial and entrepreneurial development in India. I would like to welcome Mr. Karanjkar to the podium to enlighten us with his thoughts and views on the entrepreneurial and entrepreneurial development in India.
Is this working? So I can use it from here? Thank you. Good evening.
Good evening.
What is the age of the audience? Then why good evening so low? Good evening.
Good evening.
That's it. So thank you very much for inviting me here. I'm more glad for two reasons. The first reason is about this institution, because this is the 100th year of this institution, and I'm so proud to be here because these kind of institutions have given courage, confidence and career to thousands and lakhs of people in this country. So to be here as a part of that centenary ceremony is my fortune, and I am grateful for that. Second thing, Rabindranath Tagore once said that you cannot step in the same river twice. In Gitanjali, he said that in one of the poetry, you cannot step in the same river twice, because the water flowing, it flows further. Whenever you come back again, when you put your step in the water where you stepped in earlier has gone further. This is true for the life. You cannot enter college again. The water is not same. But I think by inviting me here, and being with such youthful audience, I think I have disproven respected Rabindranath Tagore. So thank you for that. Let us go to topic now. What do you mean by startup? I'm not asking what do you mean by hiccup, because we all know what is hiccup. What is a startup? And we need to talk this, it is not a lecture, it's a workshop. So don't talk keep me talking for 2 hours and sit ideal. Don't do that. It's against your structure. Before learning the startup, we should learn what is entrepreneur. What is an entrepreneur? How you define an entrepreneur? Any answer?
Mike.
अगर ये वर्कशॉप होगा तो माइक देने पड़ेंगे ज्यादा. What is the entrepreneur?
Entrepreneur is the person who takes necessary risk for doing businesses and do innovations and.
Okay, you said two things. One is innovation and risk. Okay.
And makes adaptations in his business.
Are you reading from your mobile phone?
Why?
So, I understood innovation and risk taking. What else?
He's like the captain of the ship. He's the one who innovates as well as leads everyone.
So he gets the ship for which he needs to do the captainship?
Sir.
Or he creates the ship?
He creates.
He builds the ship?
Yes.
Or he just becomes a captain on some ship?
He creates it.
Okay. What else? Upar. Whom you call as entrepreneur? We had a very good lecture today. I heard from Principal Sir Chittale, right? About Chittale, you heard a lot in the morning. So the definition should be on the tip of your tongue. So I will tell you what is not an entrepreneur. Okay? Then we can narrow down to what is entrepreneur. Entrepreneur is not a self-employee. A person who thinks he is an entrepreneur opens his own shop or factory every day and close at the last, goes home and comes the first, is not an entrepreneur. He is a self-employed. He has kept himself as an employee, as a boss. Entrepreneur is not in a traditional way owner of a company, because he creates a legacy. Whosoever creates legacy cannot be owner. He has to detach from that. Entrepreneur is not who is very attached to his business. He is redundant person. You know who was the best entrepreneur pre-independence? You know who? Mahatma Gandhi is the first entrepreneur this country has seen. And I'll tell you how. You need to understand this concept. It is not a businessman, it's not a shop owner, it's not a factory owner. It's not a self-employee, it's not a CMD, it's not a captain of the ship. It's not a captain of the ship. I think that's why they are not smiling, you just sit there, that's good. So he is, I'll give an example. What happened in 1930? Mahatma Gandhi, you know, was a leader of the hand weaver, Windkar. The weavers. How many weavers he was running that organization for, you know? 1.1 crore. After that and before that, there is not a single union leader in communist, socialist, capitalist, democratic country who has run such a big organization. 1.1 crore members of his so-called union. It was not called as union. But he was the chief of that. One day all these people came to him and they said, Gandhiji, we cannot do this because the whatever per day we get is very less. We cannot survive in that. So other person sitting on the table was Sarabhai, who was having some meals that time in Ahmedabad. Gandhi asked him, what is the problem in giving them some increase in salary? Sarabhai said, they used to get one ana, which was 6 paisa per day, that time income. Sarabhai said, even if you increase Gandhiji 20%, I will have to close the means because it's already in the cutthroat competition for me. I am already cutting my bone, muscle has gone already, fats are gone long back. I am not earning anything. So if you increase this even by 20%, I have to stop the business. And they were demanding to be given 200%, that is 2 anas per day. After a lot of debate of 5-6 hours, Mahatma Gandhi told Vinoba Bhave that, "Vinu, you are the one-man committee. You will inquire this, study this, and let me know the recommendations. Whatever recommendations Vinoba Bhave gives, that is final and binding to both the parties." Both agreed. Vinoba Bhave, he asked, "How much time you will take, Vinu?" He said, 3 months. You see how people used to interact. And that's the entrepreneur spirit. Vinoba Bhave said, 3 months. Gandhi said, "Why?" He said, "No, if I have to do it, I will take 3 months. Straight answer. He said, "Okay." After 3 months, again the meeting started. Vinoba Bhave entered in the meeting. And looking at him, Gandhiji got tears in his eyes. Because he was walking like a very old man. He lost 21 pounds in 3 months. He entered, he sat. Gandhiji said, "Forget about that discussion about this salary increase. What happened to you? Are you not well?" He said, "No, the day when I left the meeting, from that day till today, I am living a life of a giver. I am living like him. I am eating whatever he is eating, whatever earning he is getting, one and a half per day, in that I am trying to live, and I am doing it as if assuming I have a family too. So I am eating that much, I am living his life in that small money. And I lost 21 pounds in 3 months." The result was clear. Gandhiji said, "We have to give them 200% rise." Sarabhai said, "So I should say goodbye. I should close." He said, "No." Now, at this proposition of business, where the business runner has to leave and the person who is working also should get satisfied, on this post juncture, what Gandhiji said is, he said, "You don't worry. To buy the cloth you make as a Swadeshi is my problem. I will start a movement of Swadeshi from tomorrow. Because I know how to sell this. Selling is my problem." This is an entrepreneur. He takes all kind of risk, as he rightly said, and he finds a solution which fits for all. And he is not a solution provider alone. He is an entrepreneur. So before we start, I think I should go to the entrepreneur thing first and then come back to our startup things. And I want to do that deliberately, because unless you understand a concept, you cannot get through who runs the startup. The biggest difference between ordinary man and entrepreneur is the thought process. If you, me and some terrorist goes to Lakshmi Road right now, you and me will think that what's a nice market, people are just wandering here and there, they are enjoying their shopping, they are so happy, they have money. What terrorists will think? If I put a bomb here, how many people will die? This is the difference of a thought process at the same situation. Entrepreneur has no thought process like a businessman. He is an entrepreneur, it's a different class of its own. He's a different class. He gets up every day with different things. He is not living a day of today as yesterday. He is not walking on some footprints of somebody. He creates his own footprints. That's entrepreneur. It's a very big mental change. So any one of you wants to become an entrepreneur, you need to understand. That's the reason I am covering this, and then we'll go to startup. Anytime you have any question, please raise your hand and ask me. Don't hesitate. Is it okay to start with this?
Yes.
Is it okay to start with this?
Yes.
Either I am deaf or you are not saying properly, I don't know. So what happened? Where is the wording here? There are words with these slides, they are gone? For every slide there are some words which I wanted to tell you about the freedom. I don't know. Where is that put in? Can you just go to next if that works? Because this may not work. This will change the whole slide actually. Can you enter? Enter. Oh. Why? Then There are words on every slides, no? Get my laptop.
Excuse me, sir. Sir.
Yeah.
Sir, upstairs. Sir. Sir, I have one question.
Yeah.
What was exactly the motivation for you to become a performing artist?
What is the motivation for me?
For becoming a performing artist.
Yeah, I will answer it there. Let us understand the topic first. I'll answer you, don't worry. Because I don't want to jump from this topic to that topic. I will answer you at length. Till time calls come home, I will answer, don't worry. What happened? The words have come just now, no? They can come? Just make sure that click by. So entrepreneur, the first thing it has, the entrepreneur has 10 freedoms. And which are those 10 freedoms we are going to see? Go next. No, at the end. Go next. Go at the end. Now the word should come here. Or show it like this, don't worry. Can go off. We can show like this, that format. If that full screen is not working, that's okay. Yeah. The spirit of entrepreneurship. I can do the next now, don't worry. Okay. The spirit of entrepreneurship lies in freedom. Now, how do you define freedom? What do you understand when I say word freedom? What do you understand? No answer? Don't you understand what is freedom? Yes?
Sir, the freedom is when you can do everything on your own. You don't need to depend on someone. And you have your own thinking or your own path.
Okay. What is the difference between freedom and liberty?
Liberty
is free
from restrictions.
Liberty has a restriction.
Free from restrictions.
Liberty is free from restriction. And what is freedom?
Freedom is free to do anything, but...
Means what? Just the English language, right? Think. Can you... See, you need to understand what we speak always. We say freedom means what? This was a freedom struggle or liberty struggle, which independence was? Are they called freedom fighter or liberty fighters? Why freedom fighter? Why not liberty fighters? Liberty has a frame. After we get freedom, got freedom, the independence from British, then what kind of thing we do in our country, that liberty we have. There is a border to liberty. And for freedom, there is no border. As you always say with that known sentence, sky is the limit. So entrepreneur is first symptom of entrepreneur is he need to understand his freedom or her freedom. It's very important. That is the spirit. You are free from what? That you will understand. Because the decision to be an entrepreneur boils down to the desire of freedom. I have an idea. I have a life and I have to run my life in my own way. That is a freedom. First your mind should get clear as a thought process. Then how the modalities can be worked out. Then what I will do with freedom. How I will, what one I will make for the society. How I will earn money. These are all the modalities. But for a mindset, I am a free bird from today. If that is not coming to your mind, you cannot be entrepreneur. You are a very good serviceman. You can work for a company. You can be general manager, vice president, even owner, some rare cases, but you are still a self-employed. You are not using the freedom. Let us understand this. The opportunity to continually expand your personal freedom is what distinguishes entrepreneur from those who work under the bureaucratic model. A boss, deputy boss, our boss, departmental heads, or the different department heads in the factory, in the company, and then you work somewhere in the layer, is a bureaucratic model which restricts the freedom. It has too much liberty circled down, no freedom at all. It has always cornered with some borders and some circles. That is not an entrepreneur can thrive on. Can survive in, can never. That exactly distinguishes the entrepreneur from a self-employed. The 10 freedoms which I am going to tell you now, They will help to eliminate the things you no longer wait in your life, want in your life, and to build the new better things that you do. To understand entrepreneur is the first process to understand the startup business. And then we go to hiccup. Let us understand what is startup first. Let us understand what is entrepreneur. Directly you cannot get hiccup without eating food. Now you can get hiccup anytime. No. The 10 freedoms are the framework for a permanent foundation on which to build goals for the rest of your life. Entrepreneurship is a living, is not doing service. Do you understand what is life? What we are doing? We are living a life or we are living a service? We are living a life. What we have taken birth for? Doing this job or living a life? Living a life. That thread should never be lost. First freedom. Freedom number one is ideas. The entrepreneur has freedom to continually become the person who exemplifies your deepest values, highest ideals. I can choose my ideals. Even if I tell you the story of Mahatma Gandhi, you don't need to choose him as your ideal. Entrepreneur has complete freedom to choose the ideal. Like I said to your sir when I met him, I went to Warren Buffett's office in Wall Street, Barclays office. You know Warren Buffett, right, by the way? Yeah. So I went to his office not to meet him. I don't need to meet him. I just wanted to see curiously how he works and where he works. So it was on 27th floor on the Liberty Street, behind Wall Street. And when I went there, I seen his chair, I seen his office. And when I was interacting with one of his employees, they said, yeah, one of his admin, she said, he comes generally alternate day to office and he comes for an hour or so. But what that man does in an hour, what he decides, what he has taken decision in that 1 hour, the 9 stock markets of the world, they just swing on his order, like an orchestra conductor. And they swing for a week on a decision he has taken in that fraction of minutes. That is the power of entrepreneur. That's the freedom. So you can choose your ideal. He has chosen his ideal. He has never worked like he has gone, then he has made a lot of money, and then he started opening some firms, then he has become entrepreneur. No. By thought he was an entrepreneur, he has chosen his ideals are different. So as an entrepreneur, you have freedom of choosing ideals. You have freedom of free time. You have freedom to plan for, take and enjoy increased amounts of meaningful and regenerating free time. People think this is paradoxical. Entrepreneur has full free time at his disposal or at her disposal. If you don't have that, you are a self-employed. If you don't find time for doing things you like, then you are an entrepreneur, then you are not an entrepreneur. So freedom of time. The third freedom is freedom of energy. You have a freedom of stopping all energy draining activities because you have a freedom of energy. Anything in your life which drains your energy out, you can ignore that. You have a freedom to ignore that. It can be a relation, it can be a botheration, it can be something which you need to keep on working unnecessarily. You can just decide one day that I will not work on this, I will not spend a minute. That's the spirit of entrepreneurship. You have a freedom of energy. I will work on those things where I will get energy from. Everybody had 24 hours, remember that, never forget. Sachin Tendulkar had 24 hours a day. Einstein had 24 hours a day. Every great person on the earth, to whom you believe and you follow, and your idol for you, has same amount of time as you have. So why they are different, why we are not? Because they are, in mindset, they are entrepreneurs. So to transform ourselves, you need to understand this freedom. If Lata Mangeshkar goes first for some concert,